Were you able to implement the Roman numeral? So the question now is, does it work? Does your software produce what is expected all the time? This is testing. And what we need to do as software developers and software testers is to look for bugs. And I told you in the previous video to come up with test cases using your experience only. Now I'm going to give you a few examples of what I would test. I would test, for example, a single digit. If I pass I expect the program to return me 1. If I pass V, I expect the program to return me 5. Then I would test when we have multiple digits, like 2 i's, which means 2, and 3 i's, which means 3. Then I would create a similar test that tests numbers with multiple digits, but different ones. For example, vi, xvi, and etc. Then I would try the subtractive notation. IV, which is 4, IX, which is 9. Then maybe a combination of both, like digits and subtractive notation. For example, XIX, which should return 19. And finally, some corner cases like invalid numbers, for example, VX or XXC. In this case, I expect the system to then say, no, this is not a proper Roman numeral. I can't convert it. So this is definitely a good number of tests for this software. But what we're going to discuss throughout this course is, well, is my experience enough? What do you think? Your experience is fundamental and will definitely help you to find many bugs in your life. However, it might not be enough. In this course, we will see more systematic and rigorous ways of testing software so that we can be more confident about our testing. Because in practice, if we just use our experience, we may forget one case or we may not think about another case. It is hard to know that we are done. That is a very big challenge we have when we test software. How can we be rigorous enough so that we find all the bugs? Tough question, definitely. Let's keep talking about it.